Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Hatter Dotes. We have new intro, new microphone, and of course a new video. And as the title says, this time I will show you how I do one of my favorite female characters in video games, the one and only Bayonetta, with her second look, of course. It is worth mentioning that I have already customized Bayonetta before creating this channel. And if you are wondering what happened to this doll, well, she passed to a better life. The part of her neck was broken and it was impossible for me to restore it. I made this doll in 2018 before being the Hatter Dolls. It is very special for me because it was part of the dolls that I present in my thesis support in the university in that year. And yes, customizing dolls was the topic I chose for support and it was gave me my degree in visual arts. So, to bring Bayonetta back to life again, I decided to do a costume redemption, this time giving her the body she deserves. And now that I see the photo, she looks a bit strange with Dracula's face and body. I had several mixed feelings with this project, since in the other way I'm going to recreate my beautiful witch again. But in the other way, I felt that I will suffer the same hatches and stress that I suffered the last time when I made her outfit. I'm not kidding, making those clothes the first time was a complete madness. But since I working on it before, I don't think I will have any problems this time. Sorry to say that I did not make a new concept for Bayonetta, since I had saved the old one I made for the first doll. So, without more to say, let's dance, boys! Nah, just kidding, let's get started! For this redemption, I will use a DC superhero girl for the first time, and we also replace her hands with these made-to-move Barbie hands, since they look perfect in this body. This doll is perfect for the character, as this line have articulated torsos, which is perfect for Bayonetta as she does a lot of poses. Well, the first thing, as always, will be to remove the head, and then remove all the hair from the doll. Now, I will remove the face with acetone. Remember, it has to be 100% pure and not use the nail polish, as it takes hours to remove everything. Now with an arrow, I will open holes in her ears so that I can pull her earrings later. And try to not burn myself, since the needle is hot. As in all my projects, first I prepare a wig cut that I will put on the doll's head, so that later I can glue the hair wets that I made with yarn. For some reason, the fiber of this yarn felt very fragile and it was stretching it with the iron would break sometimes. Luckily, Bayonetta with this look has short hair, so I did not worry too much about that. Now with all the hair wets glued, it's time to cut it so that it looks like she has in her second game. I cut it little by little and try to not go overboard with the scissors and try to not look extremely short. When I satisfy, I go through several cuts at the ends with the scissors so I can have a better shape. Now I brush strokes of glue and water so I can make the shape of her hairstyle with my fingers. So far, she looks a bit like Mikasa Ackerman from Attack on Titan in last season, but then she will look like Bayonetta's hairstyle. And this is how it looks. To finish, I will use a hairspray for an extra protection. And it's done. Now, I will make some body modifications to her body. Bayonetta is a woman with a very voluptuous body with big breasts and big hips, which is something that has nothing to do with reality, since we know that everything related to entertainment media they exaggerated a lot. And since this is a redemption, this time she will have the body she deserves, so I take pieces on my white Apoxie sculpt to be able to increase her bust and try to make it even and fit the doll's body. I try to get to blend completely with the body and above all not to interfere with the mobility mechanism of the torso, since for something I put the blue tape on it. With the help of a wet brush, I made the clay blend better with the doll's body. And I continue to make more modifications, this time on her hips. And this is how it looks. In my opinion, it looks good, and I think fits perfectly on the body of the doll. Plus, it can be moved without any problem. Okay, now I just discovered that I can remove the legs on these bodies, which is perfect, since this way I can better sand the body without any complications. In exchange for the last minute, I decided to position on her feet, since the character wears heels and the doll has half flat, and with this position I will make her look taller. Now with all the modifications done, I will go over several layers of paint mixed with a lot of water. This part makes me a problem, since I never managed to get the skin tone I want and mix it with the original. Well, I think it looks good, so there is no problem. With that, I will protect the paint with several layers of matte varnish to the entire body. And this is what Bayonetta's body looks like, and it definitely looks very different from how they looked before. Alright, it's time to make her outfit. Ay, Dios mío. Like everything I do on the channel, do it from scratch, I will do the same with the fabric of her clothes, make it look like leather. Or at least something like leather. And for that, I will pass paint mixed with glue and a lot of water to the entire fabric. The color I made is a mix between blue and gray, since Bayonetta has it in that way, both in her game and in Smash Bros. I try to make the paint mark to the entire fabric so I can take advantage of it when I gonna sew it. Seeing it has been doing a lot of sun and wind in Panama, I decided to take advantage of it to be able to dry the fabric faster out of my house. Now with the fabric dried together with the other 40 black parts, I can start using it. As you can see, I already marked the parts and then I cut them piece by piece. The zigzag cuts are the diamond shape cuts that you see behind her legs. I secure them each with white glue. With that, I begin to sew the pieces with a needle and thread. And with the iron, I will flatten them more. And this is how it looks on the doll's body for now. I had to glue these pieces together so I can make the diamond cut for her legs. And this is what it looks like. As you can see, this piece is completely attached to the body so it cannot be removed. I couldn't find another way to make it look snug, but I think it looks good in the end. Now, in the front part of her legs, I will sew a silver rope resembling a chain. And I'm gonna protect these seams with white glue. With a super fine Posca marker, I will make the decoration of the chains and those on her outfit, staying this way as you can see. Then I will paint everything with silver paint using a super fine brush. I will also make the paint merge with the rope that I saw on her legs. And wow, looks very incredible! And on camera, I paint the umbra symbols that are decorating behind her legs, although they cannot be appreciated too much. Now with super glue, I'm gonna stitch some snaps that I made with Apoxie. This is something that I never did on the first doll, so I decided to take the opportunity. And I made her crystals that are in front on her ankles. And the truth is that adding these things makes a complete change. To do her iconic heels, I decided to make them by making the shape with the help of her feet using pieces of fabric that I already sewed. And with some insoles from the bottom, I will temporarily glue them to her feet to be able to get the shape. I had done this technique before, so you can see in one of the videos that I have uploaded on the channel. And now with some pins, I have made the skeleton of the heel to later reinforcing it with more epoxy. As you can see, I already removed the heels from the feet and reinforcing them more with a layer of glue. Off camera, I took the liberty to make the sculpted decoration on her heels, which I shared in one of my Instagram stories. See it closely, it appears to be the silhouette of a woman holding her guns. With the heels ready, it's time to give them more life with paint. The sculpted part, I will give them several layers of silver. With black paint diluted with water, I pass it on the dead parts to give more realism. And I continue to make decorations with silver paint. And this is how Bayonetta heels looks. They look so incredible, and the best thing is that the dolls stand out with them on. It was something that I did not expect, seriously. And also, as an extra detail, I draw the umbra symbol that is decorated under her heels because why not? Returning to the top, now I will make the piece where the emblems hang and her own hair falls. I have no idea what this is called, so I translate into Spanish as poncho, and I will sew the pieces to make the pointy shape for her shoulders. Looking like this. I was testing it little by little on the doll's body to get an idea of how we'll be looking. Now again with the Posca marker, I will draw the decoration that I will later paint it with silver. Staying this way along with the decoration on her shoulders. This is one of the emblems of the first doll. And this is the new one that I made on the same rope that I used for her legs. I decided not to use real chains as will look very heavy and will eventually rust. As you can see, I made the seats emblems with plastic packaging decorating with paint. For her hair weights, I decided to use canecolon fiber that I had stored. I hate using this type of fiber since it's extremely uncomfortable to work, but I had to since the yarn it won't give me the length I want for her hair. With the emblems and weights ready, I will glue them directly in order with silicone glue. Staying this way, it looks so spectacular at first glance that I'm so speechless. And to finish with everything, with white fabric, I will sew the upper part of her gloves directly to her arms. Off camera, I put this decoration with lace, black ribbon, and chains painted in gold. Then, I paint her hands in white to resemble her gloves. Staying like this. And off camera, I paint them with pearl paint and their palms with blue paint. Now with that, let's see how she looks with all on her clothes. Wow, looks so amazing! It was worth the effort and the 2 months it took me to do all of this. I also made the decoration on her neck with the same materials I used on her arms. The only thing is missing it will be the glove on her chest, which I could do it by reusing and restoring the one of the old doll, giving it details with paint and adding more things to it. All I had to do is glue it directly to her chest and we have Bayonetta's outfit ready, which who will say that is her own hair? With that, let's continue with her face. Again, I clean the doll's face with acetone. And after having passed in 3 layers of Mr. Super Clear, I begin to draw the first line on her face. This time, I wanted to look a little more realistic with some anime touches, since I really like to mix styles in my repaints. Although it was a bit difficult at the first time with this face, since this is the first time that I work with this line of dots, and I want the eyes to come out even. Already satisfied with that, I continue with her pupils. And then draw her eyebrows. I want Bayonetta to have her classy sassy expression as she always has in her games. I must say that her games is one of my favorites. I think the most exciting part is beating the final boss then using the climax. Obviously, I played them in order from the first and second, and I'm still waiting for Bayonetta 3. I feel like she's a very controversial character, but that's what made her so unique. Plus, she has a ton of iconic lines. My favorite is, if you need to learn how to talk to a lady, ask your mom. Ah, so sassy, I love it! Going back to the video, as you can see, I already started using child pastel to give touches of realism to her makeup with dark tones for the shadows and shades of white to lighten. With that already done, I continue to retouch more with my watercolor pencils, this time putting colors in her pupils. With purple pastel, I pass a little on the corner of her eyes, and then I remove the excess. And touching up later with more color. Now that I have the colors of her makeup already marked, I can paint more her eyelashes and eyebrows with the black pencil. I continue the line of her mouth to then draw her beauty mark. Okay, I finished using the pencils, it's time to give more touches with acrylic. I pass some holographic paint to her eyelids and then outlining her lash line with black. With pearl paint diluted with water, I pass it to her cheeks to give highlights. It is an alternative if you don't have pearlets powder. And with a little metallic pink, I paint her lips, to then put the shine in her eyes with white. And protecting everything in the end with Ultraglass varnish. And that's how Bayonetta's face looks. Wow, this color that I put looks like real makeup. Off camera, I made her earrings and glasses again using plastic packaging. And this is how Bayonetta looks with everything on. Ah, la amo, she looks so classy with that sassy look. At first I'd accurated to reuse the first gun I made, but nah, I saw them were too small for the body, so I discarded them. So I made them again using wood and Apoxie, and then painting them blue and decorated with gold. As a final detail, the guns on her hands, I made them an extra set of hands that I glued directly to them. I felt already became an expert in making this type of accessories for dolls. If you are interested in me making a video tutorial of how making weapons or guns in this scale, let me know in the comments. And we all done, Bayonetta is ready! Seriously, recreating this character again was the most satisfying thing I've done so far. I'm so glad that I made these changes. So, did I redeem myself yes or not with this project? I want to know your opinion in the comments. Thanks for watching this video, don't forget to like and share, and if you like what I do, please subscribe to my channel to see more content like this. You can also follow me on Instagram to see previews of upcoming and future videos. My name is Eric, and I will see you next time, bye!